Hey, what is up, everyone? Welcome back. Holy smokes, do I feel old after looking at some of your music selections. We got like Little Uzi, Little Boozy, Little Yachty, all have little talent. Thanks, Vince the Prince, for the laugh. First thing, you guys need to check in. Answer my questions before 3:30. If not, you'll be marked absent. So my check-ins are so simple. So unless you're barfing up along, you guys have no excuse to be absent in my class. So get on that. Mr. Bernstein told me 3:30 is basically the cutoff. So check in before 3:30 if you could. Second, you probably know I posted something. Microsoft Teams is having issues, specifically regarding you guys uploading your assignments. So for now, until it's fixed, you can email me right here, shelgrenb@pcsb.org. So send me your assignments. All your assignments are due by the end of the day for both all my classes. Speaking of which, my UPC and TV2 people, your ideas are due by the end of the day, 11:59 tonight to be exact. For those of you are stuck, UPC sensation, Dayton Huntsman, you know him. It's Wednesday, my dudes. Yeah, that guy. He wants to create a newscast providing good news that's happening in Clearwater and around the world. So if you guys don't know what you're doing but want to contribute to that show, that can be your project. So get with me if that sounds like something you would want to do. You'd have to create stories, tell stories about the good things that are happening in around the Tampa Bay area and or the world, especially during this coronavirus time. And in fact, that's what my wife does right now. If you guys are familiar with the Nextdoor website, it's kind of like Facebook, but it talks about what's happening in your specific neighborhood. So my wife has found different stories. She has a partnership through her station in Nextdoor, so they are finding good things that are happening in our community as a result of coronavirus. Today, I think she did one where this woman is a substitute teacher, but she is not charging her current students. And that's a big drain on her because she's half of the income in her house, but she's doing it out of the kindness of her heart. So stuff like that is, I think, what Dayton's looking for. So let me know about that. For my TV1 peeps, some of you have submitted your basic ideas already, and that's perfect. That's all I want. I just want the idea of what you guys are going to be doing. Nothing more, nothing less. No dialogue, no characters, just a brief synopsis of what's going to happen. For those of you who are stuck, here's a few things that I looked online that may help for those who are beginners like us, all of us. The number one thing they suggest is write what you know. Whether it's a hobby that you have, or you go to church, or you play an instrument, maybe it revolves around something like that. Or I know I do. I have a couple incidents in my life where I'm like, that would be an awesome movie. That day I just had was crazy. And then we have the power, because we're writing this, we can change it any way we want. So maybe you have a crazy day, but the thing would be to change the ending to like fit a short film, something like that. So that could be an idea. I've read a few. Stay away from cliches. If you're kind of recounting an idea that you've seen already before and you're trying to make it your own, chances are a lot of people have seen it before. So unless you have a crazy killer ending or some kind of twist, it's going to be played out. We've already seen it. Also, this is basic, and this is probably goes without saying, but keep it simple, and simple from a couple regards. Keep it simple. You only need like one idea. Don't try to get all these crazy ideas mashed together. You can have one kind of central idea, and then either the character makes it happen, brings it to life, or there's, like I said, another killer ending that kind of brings it home. And simple also from the fact that we're limited with resources, so don't write a scene about like a horse stampede when we don't have any horses, or a crazy car chase, because especially some of you out there, you're going to try to recreate this car chase, and then that's going to be on me. So don't do that. Yeah, and since this is a short film, you want to grab the viewers right off the bat. You don't have really time to fool around to like plot develop. Not that you guys are going to do that, but hook them off the top. So think about that when you're writing. And then finally, you can make it more visual than actual dialogue. If you remember that film about the guy who's at the copy machine and he has that big black hole. I don't think there was any dialogue in that. So it was more about what was happening with the guy in the hole and all that stuff, whatever. You don't have to think about dialogue so much. I mean, you can have one that's cleverly written. I mean, that's fine too, but just think about that. Simpler the better. Simple, short. Know your audience, know yourself. That's it. That's what you need to know. I have posted a link on Microsoft team about this woman. She has a YouTube video, and she's talking about 10 different ideas she's come up with. She's never put them into action, so maybe either you select one of her ideas, or one of her ideas might spawn something in your head, and we'll go from, you know, it'll take off. That's the other thing. If you read, I know that's a challenging thing for a lot of you, but reading gives you ideas, and ideas create juices, and also talk to people. Talk to your whoever's in your house with you, because you're with people all the time now that maybe you like or don't like, but maybe they can give you some good ideas. That is it for now. I'm gonna play us out with one of my go-to tunes from back in the day. This would get me pumped up for my football or basketball games. You may not like it, but it's my YouTube channel, so you're stuck with it. See you guys.
Recruiting suckers, Mac and Mike, and making men of them. Tears and fears for my peers, they risen. You think that it is, if not it isn't. Race for the border, my daughter could beat her banging out. Cheeks rocking beats in the streets, and it's time for hanging out. Gather, or rather, form a circle around out loud. Just cause brothers or others could never ever rock a crowd. Is it because he's running off with the mouth? Or was he really clearly trying to play a out? Nope, shut him down, the king with the crown.